There, my name is Irene, and in this video, we'll be talking about why Sketchup is such a popular software choice within the interior design industry. So let's get to it. So the interior design industry is currently inundated with options when it comes to software. There is CAD software, there is BIM software, there is 2D drawing software, there is 3D drawing software, there is cheap software, there is expensive software. So this puts you in a situation where you actually have to ask yourself, what is the best option for me? And what a lot of interior designers end up choosing is SketchUp. So why is this? In order to understand why SketchUp has the hold that it has over the industry, it can be helpful to consider its history. So back when SketchUp was created, back in the year 2000 or something like that, the 3D modeling offerings when it came to software were kind of limited. For the most part, when it came to professional 3D modeling software, we had things such as 3ds Max, Rhino, Maya, which are fantastic programs, don't get me wrong, but I don't know if you've ever seen the user interface of, for example, 3ds Max, but it looks like the cockpit of an airplane. So basically what would happen was that most of the software for professionals was really complex. It had a very steep learning curve. And basically what would happen would be that if you wanted to have 3D modeling within your studio, within your design services, you would basically have to have a person that was like the 3D modeling person. And I know that because I was that person for many years in many different companies that I worked in. Now, those were not the only options. There were more simple programs, but the problem with those more simple programs was that you basically would have a program that didn't have a lot of options for customization. So I don't remember the name of any of those programs, to be entirely honest with you, but I do remember them. And I would compare them with the IKEA kitchen planner, for example. So you have these kind of software that it's like, yes, you can draw some walls, you can put a door, you can put a window, you can put some cabinets, arrange them, rotate them, whatnot. But if you wanted to do anything custom, you really couldn't. So what the people that developed SketchUp wanted to do was create a software that would fill in that gap, a program that would be good for professionals, but that also would be friendly enough that new users or even non-professionals would be able to use it. And this is why when you first open SketchUp, you're met with a screen like this. This is not by accident. This is on purpose. The developers of SketchUp purposefully want the program to look extremely easy, simple, non-threatening, I guess is the word that I would use. So that way anyone can feel confident to be able to work with SketchUp. Now, the counter response that that usually generates in professionals is, well, how am I going to be able to do complex and crazy stuff that I need for my job if I only have like four commands and like it looks like it's a 3D modeling program for babies? So the way that SketchUp tackles this is with customization. This user interface can be heavily edited and customized, so you can end up with something that looks like this. So this is my professional setup for SketchUp. And as you can see, it's very different than what we started with. So this is actually the main way that SketchUp operates. And you can see that guiding principle in a lot of the features of SketchUp. The program starts very, very simple in appearance and commands and functions, but then it gives you the option of adding to it and customize it to whatever level of complexity you need. You can actually also see this, for example, with the extension warehouse. There was this very interesting interview that I read about a few months ago about the latest release of SketchUp, and they were talking with a SketchUp developer and they were asking like, well, when are you guys going to put in a command to make it easier to like automatically create walls or this? And the guy basically said, we're never going to do that because we don't want our program to get too niche. We don't want it to start catering to specific industries, which is another interesting characteristic of SketchUp, especially compared with other software. In most cases, if I bring up the name of a 3D modeling software, most people will associate it with a specific industry. The developers of SketchUp also didn't want it to cater to any one industry in particular. They wanted a software that anyone could use. And this gives SketchUp a very unique edge because, especially in interior design, a lot of times we're going to be collaborating with other people, other industries. And I'm not just talking about like engineers and architects. Like if you are making a kind of like display, you might be working with, you know, like somebody who does fabric work or some kind of artist or any other person like a landscape designer, I don't know, a watchmaker. And SketchUp gives you the tools to be able to collaborate with all of these different professions because, again, SketchUp is a program for everyone. In fact, a very easy way to confirm the broad scope of a demographic that SketchUp tries to cover is with the templates. When you go to the templates, if you go and expand for more templates, you can actually get a glimpse of like all the different industries or people that SketchUp is trying to reach. So, for example, you have the simple template, which is intended for what I like to call civilians, aka people who are not professional. And it's just like, I don't know, I just wanted to make a 3D model of something. But then you can also see that there are architectural templates, there are urban planning templates, landscape templates, woodworking templates, interior templates, and even 3D printing templates. So you can really see the versatility of SketchUp. So I think that's the main driving force that has allowed SketchUp to remain relevant and important within the industry, despite that other software, which may be more efficient, more advanced, more tailored to your specific industry, have come up over the years. Now, that is in terms of what sets SketchUp apart from other more popularly used softwares within the interior design industry. That doesn't necessarily mean that SketchUp is a bulletproof program and it's a, you know, it's absolutely perfect and everybody should use it and there's no scenario where it doesn't apply. Obviously, SketchUp, like any other program, has its pros and cons. One of the biggest problems that I find with SketchUp is the fact that there is a limit to how much information it can manage. So I find that it can be a really good program if you are doing small to medium-sized projects, but if you're making a really big project, you're not going to be able to contain all the relevant information that you need within that single file. You may actually need to have like multiple files, multiple 3D models to disperse the information amongst them. Following on this, SketchUp is not really parametric. They're doing some things to make the program overall a little bit more parametric, but it doesn't really compare with something like Revit or Archicad, which are BIM software. So if you're working with SketchUp, anything like scheduling, tags, you know, labels, those kind of stuff, you're still gonna have to make them manually, which can be annoying. Also, keep in mind the level of detail. So, for example, if you're doing construction documentation, SketchUp is not really designed to work with things such as line thicknesses and hatches. You can kind of fake it with layout, which is a program that comes within the umbrella of SketchUp, but it's not perfect. And unless you're making a very simple set of drawings, I wouldn't necessarily recommend it. For that, even something like AutoCAD is better. So again, I'm not trying to say that like SketchUp is the one program and that you don't need any others, but it is a really good option. That aside, other important things to consider, SketchUp is not that good for collaborative projects. I know that SketchUp has a new feature that allows collaboration with other professionals, kind of like a cloud sharing service, but keep in mind that what makes collaboration possible is not the cloud sharing. It's all the consultants working with the same software. And it's gonna be, you know, it's gonna be a very cold day in hell the day that engineers work with SketchUp, as simple as that. That aside, SketchUp has some great advantages. Number one, it's very affordable, especially when you compare it with similar software. So AutoCAD, Revit, Archicad, way, way cheaper than all of them. It's very easy to learn. Again, like the learning curve with SketchUp is very, very smooth. And again, you can add complexity as you get better with the program. And even if you work in big companies or big projects, you can still use SketchUp. It's just that it's probably not going to be your construction documentation software, but it can be used on the early stages of design when you are doing your programming, when you are doing like initial like material application and you're just trying to figure out like the vibe. SketchUp can be a very good tool for that process. And if all of that doesn't sell you on SketchUp, just remember that the SketchUp 3D Warehouse is one of the largest libraries of 3D models, which you can access completely for free. That's usually the place where SketchUp gets me. And with that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give it a like. If you have any questions about SketchUp or other softwares, by all means, feel free to leave them in the comments. But otherwise, thank you for coming in. Thank you for sticking through, and I will see you next time. Have a good one. Bye.